What's up, interview hackers? Sam here from ByteByByte.com, and today I want to talk about the concept of digging your well before you're thirsty. And so I want you to take a trip with me for a second. Imagine that we're wandering through the desert and we don't have any water with us and we're starting to get really thirsty, right? We know that we're going to need water soon. So what time do we stop and say, okay, we're actually going to dig a well and go look for water? Well, the answer is that by the time that we are thirsty, by the time that we need that water, it is too late, right? It is too late for us to go say, okay, we're gonna try and dig a well and find water once we're thirsty, because it's gonna take us too long to actually get to where we need to go. And this is a great metaphor for business. It's a great metaphor for preparing for your interviews and developing the career that you want. Because so often what I see people do is that they wait until an opportunity arises and then they say, okay, I'm gonna try and do this thing. So many times I get people emailing me that are saying something along the lines of, oh, I have an email or I have an interview coming up next week. How can I make sure that I'm ready for my interview? And the fact of the matter is that there's not really anything that you can do in 1 week. There are some little things that you can do, and I can definitely recommend things that people can do to do better, but you are not going to be optimally prepared for your interview if you only have 1 week to do it. Rather, it would be way, way better if you, say, had a month or 2 months to prepare for your interview, because that would give you the time to really make sure that you are adequately prepared. And so I want to give you three things that you should be thinking about in advance and looking into the future to make sure that you are prepared and you have dug that well before you were thirsty when it comes to your career as a software engineer. And so the first thing that I want you to think about is your interview prep. Right? If you are not prepared for your interview, if you are not doing regular interview prep, then you are going to come upon an opportunity at some point in your career where you are not ready for that interview. You are going to have someone reach out to you, and maybe it'll be your dream job. Maybe it'll be a job that you're really excited about. Maybe it's an opportunity for a big promotion, but you're not going to be ready. And so you are going to have to rely on the person saying to you, okay, we'll let you push back your interview for 3 weeks. We'll let you push your interview back for 6 weeks or 2 months or 3 months, because you're not prepared right now. And so you're not able to go in when that opportunity arises. And so you are going to miss out on opportunities if you're not doing that regular interview prep. Now, this doesn't mean that you have to be spending hours a day every day. I would never recommend that you spend 5 hours a day every day preparing for your interviews. But it does mean being consistent. It means going in every day and saying, okay, I'm gonna do a couple practice problems. I'm gonna do a couple practice problems, maybe a week. Like, just do one problem on lead code a day or five problems a week. Just getting a little bit of preparation in so that when that opportunity does arise, you can say, okay, I am ready to go. Because just think about the perspective of the recruiter. Think about the perspective of someone looking. They're like, urgently, we need someone for this role. If you're ready to go, if you're ready to jump in and take on that job, take on that interview, you are going to be a much better candidate than anyone else that they're going to see. Number two is planning for a promotion. This is another thing where people think about a promotion as like, oh, my performance review is coming up, so it's time for me to ask for a promotion. And this is the complete opposite way that you should be thinking about asking for a promotion. A promotion is not a short-term thing. It's not something where you go into your boss and say, hey, I want more money. It's something where you plan in advance. It's something where you plan 6 months, 12 months in advance and say, I am going to lay the groundwork. I'm going to lay the foundation so that I can get that promotion, so that I am the obvious choice for that promotion in those 6 months when my performance review comes up. And so the way that you do this is when you have your performance review, whenever you talk to your boss, ask them about what they are looking for. Ask them what they would need to see from you to give you that promotion. Ask them what they need on the team. Ask them what those gaps are that you can fill in and how you can help in a meaningful way. And then do those things. If you focus on saying, okay, well, what is it that my boss needs of me? What is it that they are looking for? And how can I fill those needs? That is going to be the best way for you to then say in 6 months, when it comes time for your performance review, hey, you said you needed these things. I did this, this, and this. And because I'm working above like my pay grade, I think I deserve a promotion. Because I've been doing all these things, I'd like to get a promotion because I've earned that promotion. And so that's a great example of digging the well before you're thirsty when it comes to your actual career progression. And then finally, the third thing is learning new skills before you necessarily are going to need to use those skills. And so this is a great example of something where if you learn new skills, you are going to be the person who is going to be able to capitalize on opportunities. Right? A lot of this comes down to the idea that opportunities arise, but the big benefit is when you are able to actually capture those opportunities. So I love there was a quote from someone who said that the harder I work, the luckier I am. And it's really true for this because luck is just a matter of being able to capture opportunities when they arise. You can't control when the opportunities arise, but you can absolutely control whether you were able to capitalize on those opportunities. So what might this mean? This might mean looking at where your company is going, trying to predict, like, are there new technologies that are going to be important to management in our company? Are there directions that we're going where I can try and get ahead of the curve so that when they say, okay, we need to develop an Android app for this, you can say, okay, well, I can do that. I know how to do Android development. They want to develop, they want to start building out something using Elasticsearch. You can say, okay, I can do that because I know how to do this. This is an example of how you can dig that well and capitalize on these opportunities. Now, yes, you're going to have to pick skills and you're going to have to say, okay, well, let me focus on this or let me focus on that. And you might choose wrong, right? There's no perfect way for you to know this is what's going to be needed in 6 months. This is what's going to be needed in 12 months. But if you don't do anything, you're not going to have the opportunity to capitalize on that opportunity at all. So these are three ways that you can dig the well before you're thirsty. Focus on doing your interview prep on a regular basis, making sure that you actually are ready for interviews when they come up. Focus on how can I set myself up for a promotion in the future? How can I create an environment where my boss has no choice but to promote me because I've been doing so far above and beyond what he expected and I've been giving him exactly what he needs? And finally, how can I learn new skills so that I have the skills that I need to capitalize on any opportunities that might come up? And if you think this way, if you think in this manner in your career and in planning ahead, by thinking in this long-term way, you're going to be able to capitalize on way more opportunities than you would otherwise be able to. And so with that, that's all I got for you today. If you enjoyed this video, please go over to bytebybyte.com and check out our free guide where you will get the top 50 coding interview questions that you will see in your interviews. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video.